Hi, welcome to the statics tutorials. So with this problem, we have a truss that has a pin at A and a smooth frictionless roller at E, and we need to find the forces and members HG, HC, and BC here. So we'll do two videos. The first video is going to show the method of joints. And then the second video will show method of sections. This top part, though, is going to be the same for both. So we'll draw a free body diagram of the overall truss here. Where we have the pin at A, we'll show AX and AY. And then where the roller is here, we just have an EY. Make sure that you get all your loading in your free body diagram, so your 30, 50, and 20 kilonewtons. And then sum of forces in X will give you that AX is equal to zero. Sum of forces in Y gives you AY plus EY minus all the loading here is equal to zero. So AY plus EY is equal to 100 newtons. And then sum of moments about A, going through this one, AX and AY go through A, so they contribute no moment about A. The 30 kilonewton force sits at 4 meters over, and it creates a negative moment about A. The 50 kilonewton force is another 4 meters over, so 8 meters total, also negative moment. The 20 kilonewton force is another 4 meters over, so 12 meters total, also negative. And then we have plus EY, and EY is the full 16 meters over. So from here, we can solve for EY, plug it back into our equation, AY plus EY is equal to 100, and then solve for AY. Now that we have our reactions on both sides, we can start solving. With method of pins, we want to start at one side and take pins and just go through until we've solved for all of the unknowns that we need. We're going to start at A here because A is close to the three members that we need to find the force in. Also, A only has two unknowns. We don't know FAH, and we don't know FAB. We only get two equations when we do each pin, sum of forces in X equals zero, and sum of forces in Y equals zero. So that's why we want to start with something where there are only two unknowns. So here's our free body diagram for pin A. We have AY that acts on A, and then we have FAB that's an unknown, and FAH that's an unknown. We're going to draw everything as if it's in tension. So FAB is going to be pulling on A towards B. FAH is going to be pulling on A towards H. We do our sum of forces in the X equals zero. We get that the 4/5 FAH just from the dimensions here. So for AH, we're over 4, up 3. So it's a 3-4-5 right triangle. So FAH times 4/5 plus FAB is equal to 0. And sum of forces in Y, we get FAH times the 3/5 side plus the 52.5 kilonewtons here is equal to 0. We can solve that for FAH, and we get a negative number. So the negative means that the direction is flipped around on FAH. So we drew it as if it was in tension. Since we got the negative, that means it must be in compression. And so I write the C next to it for compression. And then FAB, we can solve for it by plugging in FAH here, and we get 70 newtons. We got a positive number there, so that means that our direction was correct and that we're in tension instead of compression. Now we can draw pin B here. We solved for AB and AH already, so pin B really only has BH as an unknown and also BC as an unknown. So here's our pin B. So we have BC and BH. We also have BA. Note that FBA is the same as FAB. They're just going in different directions because AB is pulling on pin A in this direction, but it's pulling on pin B in this direction. And then we have the 30 kilonewtons that acts at B. So we do our sum of forces in X. So minus FAB plus FBC is equal to zero. We can plug in the positive 70 that we got there. We have the negative sign in front from the direction here. And we get FBC is equal to 70 kilonewtons in tension. And then we can do our sum of forces in Y. We get FBH positive minus the 30 kilonewtons negative equals zero. And we get FBH is equal to 30 kilonewtons. It's positive, so it must be in tension. Now we can do PenH. We know AH, we know HB. So our unknowns at H are HG and then also HC. Here's our free body diagram. So we have FHG, we have FHC, we have FHB, and we have FHA. So sum of forces in the Y direction, we have negative FHA set by the sign just of the arrow drawn as if it's in tension, plus FHG plus 4/5 of FHC is equal to zero. We can plug in the negative 87.5 that we saw for over here. And notice we keep the negative sign out in front. And then we also put the negative sign in for the value. So this minus minus will become a plus in that equation. And then we'll do sum of forces in the Y equals zero. So we have the Y component of FHA. It's showing a direction down, so we put a negative sign based on the direction in the free body diagram. FHB going down, FHC, we just need the X component of that one, so 3/5 FHC going in down based on the direction in the free body diagram. And then again, we plug our numbers in, so minus sign here from the direction in the free body diagram, minus sign here for the negative 87.5 that we saw for earlier, negative, but then a positive 30 kilonewtons that we saw for earlier with FHB, and then FHC are unknown. So we can solve for FHC, we'll get a positive 37.5, so that must mean it's in tension. And then we can solve for FHG by plugging back into this equation. We get negative 100 kilonewtons, and so that must be 100 kilonewtons in compression. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next video where we'll solve this with method of sections.